Hi, I'm Tammy Heim, and I'm the president and CEO of Christian Leadership Alliance. My good friend Margaret and I were having a great conversation about leadership, and she asked me if I would share some of my thoughts with you here today on one of the things that we were discussing. We were talking about, is it really possible for someone to have a leadership style and approach, and have that style and approach work in every culture and every organization equally? Well, I know that I have certainly had a lot of experience working in a lot of different industries and in a lot of different kinds of culture. I started in department store retail, and for the first 22 years of my professional career, I was in the chaos of merger and acquisition and buyout, so we were experiencing changes all the time. And in that day, it was really important as a leader that you understood what was changing and that you adapt and that you were willing to embrace it and to be part of the change, not a resistance to the change. When I moved from department store retail, I went into specialty big box retail. And again, working with a very different kind of culture. The employees within that organization were highly educated, very intellectual. And what I found was that anything that we were doing as an organization, it required extraordinary explanation. People really wanted to understand the ins and outs of why we were moving and the things that we were doing different. So as a leader, I definitely had to adapt. I had to be more thoughtful and more prepared and really be ready to present a compelling case for why we were considering or doing something different. After leaving specialty big box, I went into Christian publishing. And again, very different kind of culture, very different kind of customer. Our customers were the authors. And in that case, we were responsible for taking their inspired work, like they were giving birth to just their innermost feelings and thoughts and putting on paper and entrusting it to us. So relationship became so important in the way that I was called to lead and respond to situations. We really had to think holistically about how every decision we made would impact our authors. From there, I went and became a partner in a consulting firm, and we worked on brand development and platform building. We worked with Christian authors. We worked with churches and we worked with other Christian businesses. And again, very, very different environment. So instead of being within an organization and influencing, I now was sitting on the sidelines. I was offering my very best thinking and trying to convince people that this was the best course of action, that this was the best practice that they could employ to get the greatest success. So again, different kind of accountability than I had when I actually was in the primary leadership role. And today I find myself in nonprofit work. We're responsible for the leadership training and development in over 4,500 nonprofit ministries around the world. And so the people that we work with, again, relationship is very important, but they are very motivated by the higher call. And that's something that unites us. So I find as a leader, when I'm talking and I'm connecting, you know, we are standing aligned on the bigger picture that we're trying to accomplish. For me, the essence of who I am as a leader, most certainly my core values, the things that are most important to me in life, have never changed as a leader. That has remained consistent. My strengths, they're pretty much hardwired in who I am. The things that I'm naturally good at, I'm good at. The things that I'm not, I'm not. But I've learned how to adapt and how to surround myself with people that can complement and can shore up the things that maybe I'm not best at as a leader. But I've always adapted. I've always had to make those adjustments and meet people where they are. I think when a leader comes in, listening is so important, learning the culture is so important, and the values. Companies often have a set of values. But you have to validate that by what you see in the day in and day out behaviors of the people within that organization. And once you understand that, only then, as a leader, can you begin to develop trust and confidence. So if you're a leader that's called to keep great momentum going, you fully understand what it is that's working, and you're willing to put your agenda inside and to the side and really invest in and continue the things that are good and happening, or if you're in a situation where you just completely have to change things up, that business as usual no longer is working,